News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hello, I'm Neil, and with me is Tom. Hi, Tom.
Good morning, Neil. Good morning, everybody else.
What's our story?
Our story today is about a phone call in space.
Okay, sounds interesting. Let's hear some more from this BBC World Service News report.
A Dutch astronaut has revealed that he accidentally called the US emergency number while orbiting the Earth aboard the International Space Station. Speaking on Dutch radio, André Kuipers explained that you make a call from space just as if you're at NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston by dialing 9 for an outside line and then 011 for an international call. But he said it's naturally trickier while floating around in space and he must have dialed 911 by mistake.
So the story is about an astronaut in space. He wanted to call Earth, to call his people, and he misdialed. Instead of calling the people he wanted to call, he dialed 911, which was the US emergency number, and there was a large panic and lots of people were concerned.
I wonder how long it would have taken the emergency services
to get to his spaceship. I don't think they went up there.
Okay, well, you've been searching around looking at the news website, so this story, and you've picked out 3 items of vocabulary. What have you got?
Astronomical, sparks, panic, and frenzy.
Astronomical, sparks, panic, and frenzy. Let's start then with your first headline with astronomical.
My first headline is from Mail Online. It says, an astronomical error. Astronauts sparked security alert at NASA's Houston base after accidentally calling 911 from the International Space Station.
So, astronomical, meaning extremely large, enormous. This is an absolutely perfect example of a pun in a headline.
It is the pun. The double meaning comes from the root of the word, which is Greek, and that is astron. Astron in Greek means star. That's why you have an astronaut, mm-hmm. or why you have astronomy. In this case, astronomical means very, very high, almost as high as the stars.
Okay, so it's got that double meaning. It means to do with space and the stories about space.
Excellent headline word.
Yep. Okay, so it means very large. Do we apply it to, for example, a loaf of bread costs, let's say, £1.
Okay.
And I went to the shop and it was, instead of £1, it was £2.
That's not astronomically expensive.
Right.
That's the advert.
Okay. What if it was £50?
Or if it was £1,000, yeah, it would be astronomically expensive.
So we're talking very, very high.
Yeah, it would be an astronomical price. You can imagine the coins going all the way into space.
Okay, yes. So we apply this to sort of quite serious subject matters, don't we? Like,
we do, yeah. So we'd often use it to talk about matters like debt or inflation. You could have an astronomical amount of debt, or inflation could be astronomical in the upcoming financial year.
Okay.
The other use of astronomical is as an adjective, which means related to astronomy. And astronomy is the study of stars and space,
which we already discussed, and that's why the headline is so good. Okay, let's move on now to our second headline.
Our second headline is from Fox News in the US. It says, astronaut sparks panic after accidentally dialing 911 from space, sending NASA into a frenzy.
Sparks panic causes strong fear. Okay, let's break this word down, though, then, starting with spark.
Spark is a very small particle of fire.
Yeah.
So if you want to start a fire, if you have 2 rocks,
yeah,
you can go like that, you will cause a spark, and the spark will cause the fire.
Yeah. If you're not living in the Stone Age, you might use a button on your cooker, for example, that causes a spark, and then the gas hits it.
Exactly. Or in your car, you have a spark plug, which is the part of the engine which causes the process of igniting the fuel, thus powering your car.
However, this story has nothing to do with fire.
Nothing.
But what it does have, what it does mean, or this expression does mean in this context, is that something very, very small caused something very, very large.
Exactly, yes. You get the smallest event, which will spark a larger instance of panic. And panic, we lot of people know, is an instance of uncontrollable fear and hysteria.
Yeah. In the south of England, I won't say the UK because the rest of the UK often does experience snow, but in the south of England, we're not very used to snow. And when it happens,
it's very surprising.
Mm-hmm.
When we get a forecast of snow mm-hmm. could spark panic.
Yeah.
People might think they're going to be snowed in and can't leave their house.
They might start panic buying. They might
panic buy, yeah.
Astronomical amounts of money for a loaf of bread, for example.
It happens, doesn't it? If people panic buy, the prices will go to an astronomical level.
Let's now look at our final headline.
Our final headline is from India. It's from the One India site. It says, Dutch astronaut accidentally calls 911 from space, sent NASA security teams into a frenzy.
A frenzy. Activity which is out of control.
It's a very good headline word. In fact, it's so good it's actually in the headline before this one as well.
Yeah.
It appears twice.
Yeah. What's so good about it?
It sounds good. It's got a Z in it, and it has these connotations of really crazy goings-on.
Yeah, it's short, it's dramatic, and as you said, it's got a Z in it. Zs look good.
Frenzy, you could use the adjective, frenzied. Mm-hmm. You could enter a frenzied panic, for example, a panic in which everyone is even more crazy.
Yeah. Have you ever seen one of those wildlife documentaries where they put a piece of meat into a pool of piranha fish?
Yes.
You know what happens after that?
There is a feeding frenzy. That's a good collocation, yes. Yeah, so that it's animals feeding, mm-hmm. but in a frenzied manner. It's really crazy and out of control.
They're not really polite in the way that they have their dinner, are they?
Animals? No, so you could say the food sends them into a frenzy.
Yeah.
And into is a very common preposition we'd use with a frenzy.
So that kind of wild chaos, that is what we're talking about with this word frenzy.
Exactly.
We often talk about people being whipped into a frenzy, don't we? Or driven into a frenzy.
Whipped, sent, driven, and there's that preposition again, into a frenzy. So we could say Rob gets driven into a frenzy every time he sees some biscuits lying around the office.
And Tom, now just a recap of the vocabulary, please.
Our vocabulary for today. Astronomical. Extremely large. Sparks panic, causes strong fear. And frenzy, activity which is out of control.
If you'd like to test yourself on that vocabulary, there is a quiz on our website, bbclearningenglish.com.
We have an astronomical amount of content.
We certainly do. But don't go into a frenzy because you've got plenty of time to look at it all. You can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. Thanks for joining us and goodbye.
Bye, everyone.
News review from BBC Learning English.